In a matter of a few years, China will be home to one of the longest underwater tunnels in the world. On top of that, it's set to be a high-speed train vacuum tunnel, which allows the bullet train to travel with far more efficiency. Today, we're going to look at this engineering marvel in detail. We'll see how it'll change traveling in the area and the massive costs of the subsea venture. We'll also see the benefit of the bullet trains in the Asian country. Finally, we'll explore some of the biggest and best underwater tunnels across the globe. So let's get started. Back in 2018, plans for an underwater high-speed railway tunnel was given the go-ahead by the Chinese government. According to some reports, it's believed this will be the world's first underwater vacuum tunnel for high-speed trains. This new line plans to link the mainland city of Ningbo and the archipelago city Joshan. Both are in the Zhejiang province and are 40 miles apart. The biggest logistic problem is the Hangzhou Bay, an area of the East China Sea separating the cities. At the moment, traveling via car from Ningbo to Zhejiang takes around 1.5 hours over the Ningbo Sea Bridge. This new tunnel will significantly reduce the traveling time to around 30 minutes, while traveling from the city Hangzhou to Zhejiang via train will eventually be around 80 minutes. Previously, Zhejiang wasn't connected to the country's main railway system. The underwater plan was included in China's big public transport ambition, the Yangzhou Railway Plan. The total line will be 77 kilometers, or around 48 miles long altogether, most of which will be newly created tracks. The underwater tunnel itself will be 16.2 kilometers, or 10 miles in length, making this the longest underwater tunnel in the country. The current champion is the underwater tunnel section on the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge. That section is 4 miles in size. The new tunnel will most excitingly have access for the famously quick bullet trains. These vehicles in China have a top speed of around 250 kilometers or 155 miles per hour at the moment. Hey, I can drive that fast. What's the big deal? Yeah, kidding, not really. Along the line will be 7 stations to accommodate as many travelers as possible. 4 of these stations will be newly built, while 3 will be redeveloped. During May 2020, drilling for the tunnel was completed after halting construction for a number of months due to the global events. In August 2020, the technical plans were then greenlit by authorities. The tunnel will be 14 meters, or 46 feet in diameter, and hit a maximum depth of 78 meters, or 256 feet, below the seabed. The tunnel will be built with the aid of an 11-kilometer or 7-mile-long tunneling shield. These large metal cylinders help make it possible for workers to build underwater. Originally, the tunnel was slated to open by 2025, yet due to the delay, it's now likely to be completed by 2026 at the earliest. This massive undertaking was estimated to cost $3.6 billion in 2018. China's high-speed rail system is constantly growing. By the end of 2020, the length of the whole line amounted to 37,900 kilometers. That's nearly 23,550 miles. China has practically doubled the size of their high-speed line since 2015. All of their various railway lines came to 146,000 kilometers, or around 90,907 miles in total. The World Bank examined China's costs on their railway lines. China was paying between 17 million to 21 million per kilometer for high-speed rail, while in Europe it was between 25 million to 39 million per kilometer. So on the high end, that means on average, China has spent nearly, ready, $796 billion on the system to date. The document also delivered that railway tunnels cost between 10 million to 15 million per kilometer. While in the US, it was as high as $50 million. So for the new underwater tunnel on the high end, we're looking at a fee of at least $150 million. This, of course, doesn't differentiate between tunnels within land and those underwater, which will likely cost more. During 2018, China planned to increase their bullet train network over the next 2 years, with a further $554 million in funding. In 2021, the U.S. think tank Marco Polo examined China's high-speed railway. They estimated that they have spent $602 billion on just constructing the actual tracks. However, the income from them has generated a net benefit of $378 billion into the economy since the high-speed rail's inception. China is also evolving their railway service when it comes to their trains. In 2020, they introduced the world's fastest driverless bullet train, scary, that can reach 217 miles per hour, while the Shanghai Maglev, the world's first magnetic levitation, or Maglev line, that opened in 2004. It can hit a top speed of 268 miles per hour. Then, last year, China began testing a maglev train that can reach a massive 373 miles per hour. Since we're talking about underwater tunnels, we can't exactly miss talking about the longest underwater railway tunnel in the world, the Channel Tunnel, also known as the Channel, or the Eurostar. This tunnel connects the UK to France, giving the island its only physical connection to mainland Europe. The tunnel is 31.5 miles long, with 23.5 miles being undersea, over double the length of China's future aquatic tunnel. Opened in 1994, the Channel Tunnel cost the equivalent of nearly $20 billion to build today, yet the first idea of the tunnel was all the way back in 1802. This mammoth construction had 13,000 workers during its peak. Vehicles are driven into shuttles that are being pulled by trains. Then, they're ferried between the nations, but there's also passenger trains available. All the trains are limited to a maximum speed of 100 miles per hour. During 2004, one of the boring machines used in constructing the Channel Tunnel was put up for auction on eBay, a piece of history for the buyer. In the end, it was sold for around $56,000. The base price of a ticket to drive your car through the tunnel is around $176 one way or $139 for a return. Another impressive example is Japan's Seikan Tunnel. Connecting the islands of Honshu and Hokkaido, this railway tunnel is a massive 33.5 miles long in total, with 14.3 miles of tunnel under the sea, making this tunnel the longest in the world that features an underwater segment. On top of its length, it's also one of the deepest tunnels around. It's built 790 feet below sea level within the Tsugaru Strait. Opened in 1988, plans for the Seikan Tunnel have been around in one form or another since 1939. Yet it wasn't until 1955, after a major typhoon sunk a number of passenger vessels, that plans began to properly form. Around 1957, once the Japanese government surveyed the creation of an underwater tunnel, they discovered it would cost $167 million at the time. The actual cost of building the tunnel that started in 1977 was much higher. It came to $7 billion back then, which would be $30 billion today. In 1976, the workers building the tunnel struck a patch of soft rock that caused the construction to flood with nearly 80 tons of seawater per minute. It took 2 months to control the leak, and no one was fatally injured. During 2012, the project to create the deepest underwater tunnel in the world was approved by Norway's government. This would be the Ryfast. Connecting the city of Stavanger to the district of Strand, the tunnel would open for the public fully in 2020. With nearly 12 miles in length total, this road tunnel is the longest and deepest subsea tunnel in the world. It's 958 feet below sea level, beating its Seikan rival by 168 feet. The Ryfast actually consists of two tunnel systems. Firstly, there's the Ryfylke Tunnel that's just shy of 9 miles in length. The second is the Hundvåg Tunnel, a little over 3 miles. Previously, cars would have to get a ferry from Stavanger to the town of Solbakk in Strand. This trip would take 45 minutes, as long as a ferry is already there, of course. With this new tunnel, the journey will take just 15 minutes. Back in 2012, the project was estimated to cost around $614 million. The cost was offset by nearly $44 million coming from grants from local governments and business communities. The remaining fee will be returned via tolls on the tunnel's entrances. Final fact finish, speaking of construction underwater, it's possible to stay in a hotel that sits beneath the ocean. The Maraca Residence is a luxury hotel room at the resort, Conrad Maldives Rangali Island. Back in 2018, a four-night stay in the Asian island abode would set you back $200,000. That includes a 24-hour butler and chef. Currently, a seven-night stay costs nearly $150,000. Thanks for joining us today. We'll see you next time.